Many here at KCCI have children.
That's right. We thought some of you might be having some of the same questions about parenting as many people do here. Katie Ward and Steve Karlin put together a special report on all this. Katie and Steve's Parenting 101. And Steve is starting things off tonight with Maisie, his 15-year-old daughter who turns 16 and gets her driver's license this week.
Are you ready to go?
I'm ready.
All right. Here we go. Here we go. Need some practice.
My soon-to-be 16-year-old daughter, Maisie, is a great kid. She's very smart, decisive, and confident until she gets behind the wheel of a car.
I thought it was just going to be fun, like just get in your car and go, but you really have to be aware of everything that's going on around you.
She's not totally freaking out.
And there's just so much more to it than I thought.
But she is quickly finding out in these last couple of days with mom or dad as her co-pilot that driving at low speeds or high can be confusing.
The freeway, definitely.
It's also dawning on her that some things done behind the wheel are not as easy as mom and dad make them look.
I really don't like parking, especially parallel parking.
And that backing up thing, if you're not careful, it can break your bumper.
It's way different than going forwards.
We want Maisie to go forward into a safe and successful driving future. But this single teen traffic statistic is very sobering for any parent. 6,000 teenagers die in car wrecks every year.
So to ease Maisie's mind, her mother's, and mine.
There's just so many things that you don't think about when you're a passenger.
I sought the advice of the Street Smarts driving school instructor.
But obviously the more they can drive, the better.
Who sat next to my daughter for 6 weeks last summer.
If a parent sees that a child is nervous in a car or any time, you know, obviously that's a sign.
A sign that Maisie and any other teenager should bone up on the 5 driving safety basics. Number 1, wear a seatbelt. 60% of young people injured in car crashes were not wearing a seatbelt. 2, slow down. 70% of all traffic accidents would disappear if people just drove the speed limit. 3, do not drink and drive. 4, limit distractions.
You know, it only takes 2 seconds for something bad to happen.
So don't fiddle with things like the cell phone, the car radio, or the iPod when you're behind the wheel. Then there's number 5. Do not crowd too many kids into your car.
You add another teenager in the car, it doubles their chance of getting into a crash.
It increases to 6 times when a second teenager is riding along.
Iowa's graduated driver's license system is one of the most lenient in the United States.
Jennings says right now there is no limit in Iowa to the number of teenagers who can ride in a car being driven by another teenager.
Iowa's teenagers rank 49th out of 50. As far as safe teen driving.
Jennings says if Maisie keeps those 5 basic driving tips in mind, she and her mother and me should be just fine.
But I hope one day it'll just be second nature.
Atta girl.
So if you see our daughter driving down the streets of Des Moines, give her plenty of room and please be patient. Steve Karlin, KCCI 8 News, Iowa's news leader.
Good tips all around. We've all been there, Steve and Maisie. Katie Ward picks up our Parenting 101 special reports tomorrow, and she's been wondering if it's a good idea to purchase an iPad or other computer tablet for your preschooler. What do you think? Katie takes a look at the good and the potentially bad tomorrow night, only on KCCI 8 News at 6.